We thank you very much. We are getting ready to begin our call and statement. I will make a statement and the church, we will respond. The first response, yes, you are welcome, spiritual leader. You can join with the team. Yeah. So our first response is sola scriptura. What did I say? Sola scriptura, which is the Bible and the Bible only. Then when we are done with that, I'll make a statement that will make you know that we'll change our response to when you pray. So when I begin the statement by saying, great things happen when you pray, you know that it has changed now to when you pray. Then after that, I'll make a statement to usher us into the last part of statement and response. Your response will be the value of a soul. Who can estimate? Let us give it a try. The Bible and the Bible only.
Sola Scriptura.
The light that shines out of the darkness.
Sola Scriptura.
The only word which is altogether lovely.
Sola Scriptura.
The only word fitly spoken as though they were apples of gold in pictures of silver.
Sola Scriptura.
The only word that is calculated to improve your intellect.
Sola Scriptura.
The only word which the angels do desire to look into.
Sola Scriptura.
The science and study of the redeemed for the ceaseless ages of eternity.
Sola Scriptura.
Great things happen. Yes, great things happen when you pray. When you pray, great things happen. Like unto Adam, God will lift up a standard for you against the devil, giving you the courage of a hero to resist all manner of evil. Great things happen.
When you pray.
Yes, when you pray. Great things happen when you pray. Prayer is the breath of the soul. In the same way that you take in oxygen to nourish your physical body, prayer is the breath of the soul. It will give you life, not only life in this life, but also life in the life that is to come. Great things happen
when you pray.
Yes, when you pray. Great things happen when you pray. Prayer is the opening up of the heart unto God as unto a friend. It does not bring God down unto us, but we are lifted upward unto God, where his light and glory shines even brighter and brighter. Great things happen
when you pray.
Yes, when you pray. Great things happen when you pray. God will make your life like that of Jesus. You will be like a vital current, diffusing life and joy wherever you go. Great things happen
when you pray.
Yes, when you pray. Great things happen when you pray. Listen, when you look into the word of God, we have an encounter. When Peter prayed, the prison doors were laid open. Great things happen. Yes, great things happen
when you pray.
Daniel in the hungry lion's den, he did pray unto God. When he prayed, those lions lost their appetite. I tell you, brothers and sisters, great things happen
when you pray.
Yes, when you pray, great things happen when you pray. This prayer is a key in the hand of faith that unlocks heaven's storehouse, wherein are laid the boundless resources of omnipotence. When you pray, great things happen. Oh yes, great things happen when you pray. When you pray, great things happen.
When you pray.
Yes, when you pray, great things happen. Prayer in the time of peace will help you in the time of need. Pray more than you speak. Pray before you can respond. God will give you words full of grace, seasoned with salt. Great things happen
when you pray.
Yes. Would you know the value of a soul? The value of a soul. Who can estimate? Would you know the value of a soul? Go to Gethsemane and there watch with Christ.
The value of a soul, who can estimate?
The value of a soul, who can estimate the value of a soul. Who can estimate? Go to Gethsemane, there watch with Christ, when he did cling onto the earth, avoiding the agony of being separated from the Father.
The
value of a soul. Who can estimate? Look at Jesus lying on the ground, prostrate on the ground, and having his sweat as though they were great drops of blood. The value of a soul. Who can estimate? Would you know the value of a soul? The value of a soul. Who can estimate? Watch with Jesus Christ in the judgment bowl. When the poor, miserable and weak man spat on the face of the King of glory.
The value of a soul, who can estimate?
The value of a soul, who can estimate? Would you know the value of a soul when the poor, miserable and weak man did scourge the King of glory? Even they that he came to die for, that scourge, even mingled with glass, entered into his flesh, ripping off his flesh and leaving his body stained with blood. The value of a soul. Who can estimate? Would you know the value of a soul?
The value of a soul. Who can estimate?
The value of a soul can only be estimated when we watch Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary, when the mob that he came to redeem, uttered a shout of degradation, a shout of an insult to the heavenly King, crucify him, crucify him, crucify him.
The value of a soul. Who can estimate?
The value of a soul. Who can estimate? You can only know it when you go to the cross of Calvary and look at the mud feet of Jesus. Look at the pierced side, the wounded head, and that utterance, the agony of separation from the Father. My God, why have you forsaken me?
The value of a soul. Who can estimate?
The value of a soul can only be estimated when you watch and see the earth turning black. Heavens not turning up their ups because their commander is dying on the cross of Calvary. A death that he did not deserve. A shameful death. He died as a malefactor on the cross of Calvary. The death that was to be yours. The death that was to be mine. Can you know? Would you know? Can you estimate the value of a soul?
The value of a soul. Who can estimate?
Thank you so very much. We are done with our call and response. Take your seats. We thank you so very much.